So yeah, got some foam today, even though it was pouring raining, but it's all in here, and gonna be cutting some wings and some boards out of this, hopefully. So an update on the chambered board, it's all glued up and I just mounted it onto the table. And now I'm going to take the CNC and face this top side. I'm probably gonna take about 2.5-ish millimeters off. Then I'm going to flip it, do the other side, take another 2.5 off, and then cut out the profile and get started with the rest of the shaping. On the chambered board, I now have it flattened and just kind of cut out the rough outline. So far, so good. It's lighter than you'd think, but still not as light as I would like to see. Now I'm just kind of going to go in and give it the final shape to it, and we'll see how that does, because I know there's a lot of wood around the edges, and that's what I'm about to take off. So we'll see what happens there. So I gave this a nice sand. I got the rails looking nice. Here's the front up in here. And then the back. So it's pretty much done. I do like how it came out. It isn't as light as I would have liked. This one was, I just weighed it right here on the scale. This gives me grams, but this was 3.8 kilograms. So that comes out to, I think it was like 8-ish pounds. Whereas this is the normal board. So it's not chambered at all. This was a whole kilogram lighter, kilogram and a half lighter. But the big chambered board is lighter than the old board I was using, and this was a kilogram heavier, so about 2 pounds heavier than this board. You can definitely tell that it's hollow. Let me see if I can get that for you guys. It's cool. I think it's cool. I just wish it was lighter, but the thing is, it definitely has a ton more float than say this board and even this board. So of all of these boards, it definitely has the most float, and it just feels good when you grab it. It's got some nice thickness to it. It was a cool build. I don't think I will glass it up. I'm just going to kind of keep it. So yeah, I'm probably just going to keep this as is. I'm not going to glass it. It's just a bit of a learning experience. I think it would just be way better, and I'm going to make pretty much the same board, but out of foam. So that'll obviously be extremely light, extremely buoyant. So I think that's the way to go. But I did kind of think of a different way to make a chambered board, or something like a chambered board. It's going to be interesting, let's just put it that way. But basically, instead of putting the chambers running this way in the wood, I think I'm going to come up with a design where on the CNC you come in and route in the chambers going down, and then it's just a matter of putting a thin skin on the top. And I'm thinking of maybe even not even doing a skin, so it might even just glass right over the top, which, frankly, I don't know if it's going to work. I've seen one guy do it before, which was pretty cool, but so that's definitely the next chambered style board I think I'm going to give a shot. Okay, I apologize in advance for the noise going on in the background, but so our top coat has now cured. And you can see everything's looking really great. I mean, the top side finish is fantastic. Great reflections there. Same with the bottom side. And all we really have is just a very slight tape line going around the edges. So I'm just going to lightly knock that down with some high grit sandpaper, and I'm going to give this board a sanded finish. You could ride this board right now as is with the gloss finish if that's what you prefer, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some 400 grit sandpaper and I'm going to wet sand, which pretty much just means you put a little bit of water on the board and then you take your sandpaper and you start sanding. And it'll just give it a, it'll take that shine away. You know, you won't see the wood grain as well, but I like a sanded finish. A lot of boards come with sanded finishes already, and you can polish it all the way up to 1,000 grit if you want. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that, but we'll find out. So that's what I'm going to get started on next. So super simple to wet sand, right? I just have a little bit of water, put that on. Here's my sandpaper. And you just go to town. Your sandpaper will not get all gummed up. You're not making any dust. It's just, I don't know, once you kind of discover it, you're gonna be wondering why the heck you weren't doing it before. So definitely a cool thing to know.